So today we were focused on combining like terms. So we had them thinking through in expressions and equations. Yesterday we had them really focused on what is the definition of an equivalent expression. So if they have one input for a variable, they should have the same output.
The reason we're doing that is because middle school math is really important in the real world. But we're talking about how to represent different situations in terms of like stories, tape diagrams, equations. So today we were working on using those expressions and making them into their lowest terms in order to represent situations.
Today we're going to be talking about combining like terms, meaning we're adding units that are the same. You're heading over to today's Desmos and you are going to click two squares and try to combine the terms. What if I give you something that is factored? Let's use our critical thinking skills.
I could expand it so it can be easier.
You should expand it first.
Beautiful. You're going to choose that one and which other one?
And x plus 8.
Okay, what do you need to do to that group of 3 to the quantity of before?
Can we log in?
X and 6.
Can't do.
Which he can't do because they're the same. They're not.
I would like two expressions, please. Make it a little spicy. Sharon.
I did 8x plus 8 plus negative 3.
Any other spicy ones? Jaden?
I mean, negative 2x minus 2 and 8x plus 8.
How many terms? Say it. 4. Great, we're getting quicker with it. Any others that I have a like? Juliana?
8x.
Juliana said that these are the same terms. Or they have like units.
I partially agree with you, Juliana, and I think it's negative 2 plus 8.
Why not this, though? Because I see this often. I see people see this and go like this.
Both of them need to have x, but 8 doesn't have the x after it.
Yeah, what does addition mean?
There's something special with addition, division, and subtraction that like prevents this from happening. Jenny.
Combining two or more quantities and the same units to get a sum.
Yeah.
Okay, so we could do 3x plus 6, and then x minus 2.
And then plus x minus 2.
And then do 8 times x if you don't know the value of x.
We just do 8x because it's just a variable.
So 8x and then we do
minus
3?
No.
Minus 24?
Mm-hmm.
Are you just doing 3 at a time?
Yeah.
I love that. Love it.
8. Plus 8, and then in parentheses, x minus 3. Keep them separate for now until we find out how many terms we have.
Now we're going to expand it and rewrite it into this form. So that's what the rest of them are writing, or is just those two versions? We have the factored form and the expanded form.
I'm going to write it here so we can keep relying on it, okay? Let me know what questions you have. Take a look at it first.
Jerry, can you read what the directions are?
Select two or more squares, write their sum using the fewest number of terms.
What are we getting out of that?
We have 4 squares.
Okay.
And they're all different.
Okay. They're different what? What is that? They're different expressions because there's no equation sign. Okay, let's do an example, and then I want to hear you guys talking yourselves through it.
8x plus 8.
Love it. Can everyone click on the 8x plus 8? Okay, what are the terms that you see? First of all, I want you guys to chat. How many terms do you see? And then which terms do you think are similar that we can combine? Okay, can you guys chat about it, and then the two of you can chat about it? Do you know which ones are similar that we can combine? Can you show me all 8 of the x's? What do you think was easier? Everything he just drew or just saying 8x? Right? So why would we say I have x and 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 x when I can just say I have... So this is just a short version of all my variables, okay?
Does that count as like expanded form? Because it's like expanding the 5.
Yeah, I mean, you could say 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. When you were in younger grades, you would have written it as like 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. That's the expanded version of that. So now that we've just chatted about it, I'm going to do some walking around with Miss Reen. You guys are trying to combine as many squares as you can. So pick 2 at a time. Combine them like the terms, okay? Then pick 2 more. Combine the terms until you've done all of them.
We try to collect enough data that it feels like we are reaching all students. We are always looking at their cool downs. Rahima and I try to actually grade every single assignment that they do at the end of class and get that data back to them. And they have many times throughout the day to look at that data and look at their work and how they did in each class. Okay, so you picked those two. And if you combine those terms, can you combine them, first of all? Why?
Because they're the same unit.
What is the unit that they are?
X.
They're, so which we call our variables, right? So what do you have all together when you combine your variables?
Negative 1x.
Beautiful. Can you keep track of all of the ones that you're doing, though? Because I want you to be able to reference how many times you combine terms. Sharon? I love that. Why did you choose to add a negative instead of just writing subtract?
Because here it says 7x minus negative x to me. I thought that you would do... You would go from 7 minus 8 to get to negative 1x, and then add the 6.
So it made more sense to think of it as a negative instead of, like, subtracting? Beautiful. Wait, I'm loving the debate. Fill me in. Fill me in.
We did.
Okay. Can I write them? Can you tell me?
8 times the quantity of x minus 3.
Okay.
Plus.
And plus.
You could do a sky.
Negative 2. Wait.
No, you got it.
Times the quantity x plus 2.
Okay. Negative 2 times the quantity x plus 2? Did I hear that correctly?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. So what was the debate we were having? Because I heard, like, we're adding, we're subtracting. Exactly.
Then we could see how much terms we have.
Okay. How can we even start doing that?
Like, expression?
Oh, look at the variables.
Yeah, look at the variables in the parts.
Okay. Do you think we should keep it like this, or do you think we should factor the 8?
But
we should factor.
I thought it was already its own variable because it's a positive.
Say more.
And, like, it's a positive of this. So, like, why would it be its own?
This one would be its own?
Expanding the 8.
Can you come do it? I'm going to check on Jacob.
All right.
Because it's a...
Eight exit.
Okay.
What did Zoe write out?
Eight X's.
I would say, beautiful. I love that you did the 8 X's. But if we're thinking about it as the whole quantity, what could we change here to say we're doing the whole quantity?
I did that.
I know, I see it. Is that what this is?
No.
Yes.
And then who told you not to?
Then?
No, because she said she wanted to put the X with the 8, so you just...
No, I didn't. I was going to write X.
No.
Okay, but could we do the X's 8 times and then... Could we just do the negative 3 8 times?
Yes.
We could do that. We could do it 2 separate. I think it's a little easier to write x minus 3. I'm with Zoe, sorry.
Oh, that's because this one's 5. X plus 1 minus 2 is 7.
Three x?
Yeah. I'm big x. Watch. I told you.
Yay!
Good job, friend.
What you have to do is you have to go through all the equations for the negative 2x to the quantity of x plus 2. You have to expand that equation, which would be negative 2x plus negative 4. And then you have to, for the x, you have to, for the negative 2x, you have to go back and add all the x's up to each other.
In like expanded form, it's going to be negative 2x plus negative 4.
Yeah.
So if x doesn't have a number with it, we can't add it to a number, like 1x. So
if x isn't... I just have x, what does that represent?
1x?
It's representing 1x. So just because we don't write the one, doesn't mean it's not there.
Okay.
As I was going around to groups, what were the same questions that I were asking over and over and over again? You know, we call them our ask yourself questions. What were some things that you were hearing me say to you over and over again? Rigo.
How many terms?
We said, how many terms? We then said what? Lily.
Did you expand it?
Did you expand it? One thing we've been working on in seventh grade math are these ask yourself questions. So before you can ask a teacher in the room, we want you to put your critical thinking hat on and ask yourself these questions. They're able to lead these conversations within each other and not have to rely on us as adults because they hold their own education in their hand. So when I was looking at x minus 2, I know there's no operation in front of x, which means it's automatically what? It's automatically positive. But what about this 2? Like, some of you were like, and then there's 2. 2 is what here? Using what Joniel just shared. Jenny?
Negative.
Why is it negative? Oh, Jenny.
It's negative because if this subtraction, if the minus symbol is before, it's going to be a negative.
So this was x and negative 2.
We had some questions at the U table, though, of like, I thought that was subtraction. What happened? Like, it used to be x minus 2.
How else can I write it?
I thought that used to mean subtraction. That was the question you asked, Guy. Like, I thought this used to mean x subtracted or x minus 2. Why is it suddenly now something different?
We just automatically were like, it's negative 2. And that makes sense to us? No. So how else can I write this? Think back to floats and anchors. Whoo, seems like so long ago. How else can I write this? Jerry, you think you got it?
I think you can do x, and then I think you put parentheses around the t.
What does this expression mean in terms of floats and anchors? Maher?
There's x amount of floats, and there's 2 one second.
Yeah.
And that's subtracting 2 anchors.
If this is removing, this is what?
Floats.
So
think of it as removing floats, or we can think of it as...
Say it.
Adding anchors.
So wait a minute. It could be subtracting, removing, or it could be it's just a negative?
That is why that note we made yesterday kind of wraps it up. We knew that removing floats was the same thing as adding anchors. That is why the sign in front of the number is telling us whether or not it's positive or negative.
Working with the same curriculum for a few years, we pinpoint where the last cohort struggled and thought about different strategies to help scaffold back for our current scholars. This is also used by looking at prior units in order to recognize we have a little bit of struggles recognizing positive and negative integers and using that data in order to go through each group and be like, okay, what did you do here? You missed this sign. It has to be positive or negative. How do you know it is? And just recognizing that that's an area of struggle year after year.
Once you were done with your cool down, upside down in the middle of the table, please. Your concept claim could be something with terms, it could be something with equivalent expressions. I love that people are circling their terms right off bat.
So when you're doing your ask yourself questions, how many terms you can't know until you expand it out. So expand it out first.
So it's not just 4x, it's actually... Like this is making that amount of copies.
But make sure this negative goes into both terms. What do you mean, can I do it?
Because it has an x and this one doesn't.
So do you think they're like terms that you can combine?
No.
The short outcome of students doing deeper learning is that they're able to take what they've learned in 6th and 7th grade and really apply it. I think 8th grade is the application year. Long term, we really want them to be able to see themselves in the math as they go into high school and feel more familiar with it.
Deeper learning for me is taking what you learn in the classroom outside of the classroom, having you prepared for life. It's not enough to just get the answers right on a test because that's not what matters in the real world. There's not tests for everything. So being able for them to realize like, oh, this is more than just MCAS or this is more than just this end of unit assessment, like this is life, is something that resonates for me for deeper learning.